fellow Toastmasters, dear guests. I would like to start with a question to the audience, mostly to the young people present. What is Valar? Is it a city, or a river, or an island? What is it?
An island.
Island. Our audience is very educated. Thank you so much. And usually it is more known to the older generation who were traveling and are traveling more here in Russia than abroad. For me, this geographical name was a sort of mystery. Of course, I've heard about this island with various miracles in the past. But there was one moment that urged me to act. In May this year, my granddaughter was there on excursion, and I decided that it was really improper for me to lag behind the young generation. So, let's find facts about the place I was attracted to and the place I finally visited just a week ago. First of all, about the location. This island is situated in the northern part of the Ladoga Lake, lying in Karelia. It covers over 50 islands, and Valar is the largest of them. The largest of them, and we decided to visit it, and the aim of my project is to make you follow our example and to join the same excursion maybe sometime later. You can get there by ship from St. Petersburg, like we did, and then I decided to learn about the origin of this name, Valar. And I learned that it had come from the Finnish Ugric word Valaama, that means high mountain ground. The climate of the island is unique. You can imagine that it is the north, but it has more sunny days than the nearby mainland. And it was quite true, because we were on the lawn for around the clock, and almost all the time it was sun, no rains, while it was quite the opposite in St. Petersburg, which is 200 kilometers from Valar, and there we experienced terrible wet and cold days. The island is covered with pines. So here is one of the landscapes. Maybe you see something familiar to you. Don't you think that it looks very similarly to Shishkin, to his wonderful painting Korabelnaya Rocha, that is grove for sheep. I learned there that Shishkin used to come to Valar, and even now you can see wonderful pines for sheep. Valar is best known as the site of the 14th century monastery. 14th century, but the first mansions date back to the 10th century. It was widely supported by the Russian Tsars and the Russian Orthodox Church. History of the island is very interesting. The island saw a lot of authorities. First, it was the Novgorod Republic. Then, it was conquered by Sweden. Then, Russia reconquered it a century later. In early 19th century, Grand Duchy of Finland was set up, and Alexander I made Valaam a part of this Grand Duchy of Finland. Therefore, in 1917, when Finland got its independence from Russia, Valaam became a part of Finland. And only in 1944, it was acquired finally by the USSR at that time. For several centuries, Valaam was a religious and cultural center. The monastery was completely self-sufficient. The monks who lived there not only produced the necessary products, but they grew up even watermelons and melons. You can understand that it's rather unusual for that place, for the north. And it's important to note here that the soil on the island is absolutely inappropriate for agriculture. So you can see here the primary soil, you see, rocks. And so what did the monks do? They composed new soil. They put new soil on the rocks, and they grew up wonderful gardens. We saw fruit gardens that are over 100 years of age, and still the apple trees are fruit bearing. From 1944 to 1989, the monastery was closed. One minute more. Monastery was closed. Now it functions again. And finally, though, because my time is up, a few words about my impressions. Why do I invite you to join the same excursion? What impressed me mostly there? The Cathedral of Transfiguration, that of course was very gorgeous after very well done restoration works. Our excursion was added with a small concert of clerical singing. There were wonderful bass singers, and they completed their singing with singing "Многие лета". You can understand many years to you. For me, it was of special importance because it was the day of my birthday. We visited their three hermitages where monks lived and live now in seclusion. They are located amidst wonderful nature, full of pine forests, or rocks, hills. So nature is really fantastic there. The whole place has a unique aura of grandeur, purity. It's really a sacred place, believe me. Though in general, I'm an atheist, but there is something about this please. People there are mostly smiling. They are very polite. They are always ready to help you. So if you would like to experience something that will give you the new thirst for life, that will give you peace, like it was with me, join this excursion. Now, according to the rules of this project, you must give questions to me. 2 or 3 minutes period of questions. Yes.
I understand. I think that island was used a lot by Stalin for prisoners, and that a lot of bodies and things were recently discovered there. Did you take a look at any of that?
Yes. You see, the first post-war years for Valaam were very sad. In our country, as a result of the war, there were many invalids, disabled people without hands, without legs. And according to the authorities' order, many of them were taken off the streets of the big cities and were exiled to Valar. And for many years, they lived there in terrible conditions. That's how it is. It was used for this purpose. As to repressions, I mean, I think you mean, no, it wasn't used. You maybe mixed up a little bit Valaam with Solovki. Solovki was the place for the concentration camp. Mm-hmm.
Have you seen alive ones? And if you have, what was your impression about them?
Of course, I have seen the monks there. In general, they were passing by many excursion groups that are there, and they looked like very business-like people. They were very busy. Yes, I had no opportunity to speak to them somehow. But nevertheless, I think if I could speak, I could get very clear and polite answer. So, as I mentioned here, people there were very polite and ready to help you if you need. Yes.
Where did monks get appropriate soil? Was it brought by ships or not?
You see, there are different legends to the point. And one of the legends is that in the 19th century and in the 20th, especially in the 19th century, yes, there was a rule for any person coming to the island to bring a sack of ground. Maybe it is so, maybe not, I don't know.
Is it expensive to go there?
I don't think so, not very expensive. I don't belong to the group that can afford expensive trips. Yes?
Have you seen some animals?
Some animals? According to literature, according to our guide, very pleasant young man, yes, there are many animals on the island, but I was unlucky. I didn't see them.
I didn't catch. And who is the owner of this territory?
You see, this territory, it's a very interesting detail. This, for administrative subordination, yes, it belongs to Sertavala, urban settlement. This town of Sertavala is 42 kilometers from Valaam. But this settlement, secular settlement of Valaam, belongs to this Sertavala town. Yes? But now they are fighting for independence. Yes, and the secular population of Valaam wants to have separate administrative status. But the monastery is doing its best to delay such development. They don't want the secular people having separate administrative status. Maybe they are afraid of some excessive buildings to be built, I don't know.
But now they belong to Leningrad region.
No.
No?
They belong to Karelia. It's the territory of Karelia. Thank you so much.